of the most important choices we ever make in life is that of deciding who our friends will be. This is Night Sounds. Bill Pearce is my name, and I welcome you to this next half hour of what we often call togetherness. I would like to be your friend, and I hope you'll be my friend, even if we've never met. Before this next segment of programming is over, that some sort of a fusion or bond will be established. I've often said that because of the type of work I'm in, where I meet thousands of people constantly, those whom I've never seen and probably never will see, through the airwaves, we hear from some of you. And in concert, you may be performing or ministering to thousands of people, you only meet a small fragment of them. Many acquaintances, but very few friends. Tonight, our program is subtitled, Merely Friends. We begin with the one friend, according to the Holy Bible, who sticks closer than a brother. This Jesus, God, he is beautiful. As one young man who was converted from the asphalt jungle of New York said, in his own vernacular, I mean, this Jesus is really great. He's not at all pretty or sick beautiful, like some of those pictures we see of him that Christians hang on their walls. He's not like that at all. He's real. He's got soul. What he did is something else. There's nothing like it. You see, when this Jesus came on the scene, God was like a stranger to people. Oh, they thought they knew him, but they didn't really. Jesus knew him. That's why he didn't fit in with other people. He was himself. He didn't have to copy anybody. He did what he had to do. And he kept on doing it till they couldn't take it any longer, so they killed him. He did his thing because he was Jesus. He cut through all the phony ideas of the priests and leaders and told them the truth. And he still does. He really knows the truth about God, and it's wild. This man, Jesus, is really beautiful. Let's just center on that very descriptive word right now.
Beautiful Savior, and we worship you.
Lord, it's lovely
beautiful. You are Jesus. The Maranatha Chorus opening tonight. As we speak, read poetry, play music about friends. What is a friend? A friend is a very valuable person with whom you dare to be yourself. Your soul can go naked with him or her. They seem to ask you to put on nothing, only to be what you really are. When you're with your friend, you don't have to be on your guard. You can say what you think, so long as it's genuinely you. They understand those contradictions in your nature that cause others to misinterpret or even misjudge you. With a real friend, you breathe freely. You can avow your little vanities and envies and absurdities, and opening up to him, they are dissolved on the wide ocean of his or her loyalty. The friend understands. You can cry with him, laugh with him, pray with him. And underneath it all, he, she, sees. They know they love you. A friend is one with whom you dare to be yourself. Dear Lord, my friends have been to me interpreters of love divine. And in their kindness I have seen your everlasting mercy shine. And so I pray that on this day you will search through gifts of yours and choose your rarest, fairest ones to shower upon these friends of mine. Joseph Clark wrote, "Thank God for you, good friend of mine. How scarce is friendship such as thine. How very much I wish to be as helpful as you've been to me. I thank God for you. When I recall from time to time how you inspire the soul and heart of mine, I find myself inclined to pray, God bless my friend, this very day. I thank God for you." Another prayer offered by writer W.R. Hunt. Dear Lord, please give me a few friends who understand me and remain my friends. A work to do which has real value, without which the world would be the poorer. A mind unafraid to travel, even though the trail is not blazed. Please give me an understanding heart, a sense of humor, time for quiet, silent meditation, a sense of the presence of God, the patience to wait for the coming of those things with the wisdom to recognize them when they come. Lord, please give me a few friends who understand, who know me and will remain my friends. Thank you for being a friend. Amen.
Not the words that I say, not the deeds that I do, not the songs that I sing, these alone just won't do. Not by giving my all to those that I see in need, not by telling to men you're ready and willing to lead, but it's many by many, day by day, giving my life over, Lord, to you. All is many by many.
Draw me closer, Lord, to you. Duane and Gail Hamilton singing tonight. As we speak together and think about friends. Your friends, who are they? Why do you choose them as friends? I think if we have a good many acquaintances, and I alluded to that a moment ago, if we're really faced with the question, who is your true friend, it begins to narrow down the field. Friendship is a priceless gift that cannot be bought or sold. But its value is far greater than a mountain made of gold. For gold is cold and lifeless. It can neither see nor hear. And in the time of trouble, it's powerless to cheer. It has no ears to listen, no heart to understand. It can't bring you comfort or reach out a helping hand. So when you ask God for a gift, be thankful if he sends not diamonds, pearls, or riches, but the love of real, true friends. Ever notice how those who are friends or would be friends often touch one another in a healthy way? I read a title of a book not too long ago. It was called Hugged Into Shape. I heard somewhere where we need at least 4 hugs a day to remain psychologically healthy. I can see the disciples hugging one another. I can see them hugging Jesus, and he in turn with a word for each of them, personally, individually, and calling the whole group together to share things, and they interact with each other and then spread out to touch others with that love. That's what we're about tonight, and I wish that it were possible for me to give each and every one of you a good bear hug right now, to tell you that you're valuable, that I respect you, that God loves you. And he loves me, and he's drawn us together in this love. Often sometimes when we can't say words, it's wonderful what a hug can do. An unknown author went on to say, a hug can cheer you up when you're feeling blue. A hug can say, I love you so, and I don't want to see you go. A hug means welcome back with joy. It seems that you've been gone a year. A hug can soothe a small child's pain and bring a rainbow after rain. About a hug, There is no doubt. It's something we really can't do very well without. A hug will warm, delight, and charm. It must be why God made an arm. Hugs are great for favorite ants. It'll help them more than potted plants. Even kittens crave them. Puppies love them. A hug can break the language barrier and make the dullest day far merrier. So stretch those arms without delay and give someone a hug today. Wouldn't you like to be hugged by Jesus? Well, not physically, it's not possible at this time, but spiritually, he's giving us all a big hug right now. It's an old favorite, isn't it? Everybody knows that one. What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Everything. We can come to him with the dirty laundry and the deep, dark secrets we wouldn't share with just anyone. Even a best friend, I suppose there is a limit. But with Jesus, a friend that sticks closer than a brother. Friends, real friends, wear well. There are no friends like old friends, and none so good and true. We greet them when we meet them as roses greet the dew. No other friends are dearer, though born of kindred mold, and while we prize the new ones, we treasure more the old. And when they smile to gladden, or sometimes frown to guide, we fondly wish those old friends were always by our side. And when our faltering footsteps approach the great divide, we'll long to meet the old friends who are waiting on the other side. Bit of verse here by Nixon Waterman, who wrote, "If I knew you and you knew me, if both of us could clearly see and with an inner sight divine the meaning of your heart and mine, I'm sure that we would differ less and clasp our hands in friendliness. Our thoughts would pleasantly agree if I knew you and you knew me." And tonight on Night Sounds, we're speaking to the subject of friendship. Here's a bit of verse written by someone who just calls herself merely Connie, talks about the forever kind of love and friendship. Lord, grant us the forever kind that sees the faults but doesn't mind. The kind that says, I love you still. If not by feelings, then by will. The kind of love and friendship that's like your own, Lord, that seeks to serve, not earn reward. The kind that sees the best in each, that seeks to pray for, not to preach. And when old age should take its toll, look beyond and love the soul. Be thou our anchor and our joy, a steadfast love time can't destroy. A friendship, a love made choice to always stay, to be there till our dying day, and then when death comes to break earth's spell, Lord, may you tell us, you were a real friend, you loved well.
There's not a friend like the lowly Jesus. No, not one. No, not one. None else can heal all our souls' diseases. No, not one. Jesus knows all about our struggles. He will guide till the day is done. There's not a friend like the lowly Jesus. No.
God, I thank you at this very moment for the greatest love and friendship we could ever imagine that is available to us all right now, each and every one of us, no matter what our track record has been, our past, our condition right now, our attitude. I ask in the name of Jesus Christ that you touch that one who is needy and hurting right now, with this relationship, this true, everlasting friendship, this unconditional love that cannot be defined or measured or assessed. May we then reach out and touch others and radiate that same love, respect, and friendship that you have so freely given to us. Thank you for friends. May we be a friend, each one of us, to someone. Amen. I've enjoyed this half hour with you very, very much. Thank you for sharing in it. Thanks for being my friend. If we can help further than the program, our mailing address is Nightsounds, Post Office Box 29, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. Our email address is nightsoundsradio@aol.com. Till next time we get together in the circle of friendship, a great day to you tomorrow, and a very pleasant, warm, and beautiful good night.